the chance, I was told the story of Mr. Opportunity, the very sneaky fellow indeed. In his name, Mr. Opportunity passes by your house every morning, and if you can catch one of his ears, you grab the opportunity for the day. But as I was to discover, Mr. Opportunity was not easy to catch. As I grew a little older, I tried to define opportunity for myself. Opportunity for me was something that I could only find in the land of milk and honey, Silicon Valley to be precise, where the home of Microsoft, Google, Facebook, and Twitter. However, as I grew a little bit older and a little bit wiser, I discovered opportunities are found in the hardest of places. As is the story of my life, I met my first great opportunity when I repeated the fifth grade. And I met a teacher who told me I was actually a bright student despite my periodic doubt tendencies. She told me that I could make it and I could be anything if I could only look at the potential within me and the opportunities around me. With this newfound faith in my ability to succeed, I rose to the occasion, and here am I today. In my country, Zimbabwe, people speak about the percentage of unemployment, 94%, very scary figure. But for me, I found an opportunity to mentor young people, to tell them that they can, and to look at the opportunities around them, and to build businesses that do not die in the first 5 years. We look at Nelson Mandela. In the winter of 1964, he found himself at Robben Island, where he spent 18 of his 27 years in prison, a cell as his confinement, a hole as a bed, and a bucket for a toilet. And in that space, he found an opportunity to mentor his fellows, and today we celebrate him as an icon of peace and an icon of good governance and leadership globally. In Angola, Queen Zinga Mandela, born in 1383, is today celebrated because of the participation in the political emancipation of Angola. Today we say viva to Queen Zinga. But you're asking me, Kudzai, where are you going with all this? Think outside the boss, they all tell you, but I say burn the boss if you can. The problem is, you talk about the wars, the famines, the disasters, we can move on and on and on. You do not go away. But it takes one person, who I'm looking at today, who believes in themselves and their ability to transform individuals and their ability to transform nations, and who believes in the potential of Africa. I speak of an Africa without aid, but an Africa with its own growing potential. And somebody says to themselves, I am going to dig until this ground breaks forth with water. So, oh my fellas, whatever mud you can find yourself in, whatever mud our people are in, therein lies the inability to mold for ourselves as leaders a beautiful pot of clay. But this pot of clay of leadership must be based on one thing, which is ethics, the heart of this chamber. With ethics, I want to speak to leaders today who will go home and do things that are right and not easy. Leaders who heed to the cry of Africa for democratic servant leadership. Leaders who strengthen policies and legislations that provide a fertile ground for Africa to succeed. Leaders who share the resources of Africa with the African people. Leaders who serve Africa and who do not serve themselves. Leaders who value equality. Leaders who value equality and understand that every person in here and out there has been born free and has the right to exercise that freedom. Leaders who embrace the values that when we have peace, we do not have wars. When we have love, it drives away hate. When we have solidarity, it stabilizes nations. And the leaders that I'm speaking today with, then you go home to tomorrow or today and raise the capacity of Africa, the capacity which is the people that we purchase to lead. Then and only then can we talk about turning our garbage dumps into recycling plants and recycling plants into realities. If we do not embrace ethics, we are not going there and we do not have opportunities. And then, you're probably asking me, so Kudzai, what are you saying? I want to ask you one thing. Shall we continue to cry about sanctions? Shall we continue to cry about who colonized who? I say no. Africa is not the future. Africa is real, it's present. Yes. Africa is happening now.